everyone, and today we are going to do The Little Girl from Class 9 book Beehive, written by Catherine Mansfield. On the looks of it, you may feel that this is a story about a little girl and her family and the incidents that happen in that family. But metaphorically speaking, the story gives us a different insight. It tells us how we perceive our fathers, especially. We often feel that our fathers are very strict, they are disciplinarians, they pose authority, and we feel that it's very difficult to please them. But when we read this entire story, your thoughts will be provoked on this basic idea that fathers are not how you see them. Fathers are actually very kind-hearted, very soft-hearted, and as emotional as mothers. So let's read and understand the story today, which is written by Catherine Mansfield. And after that, we will discuss the summary, the significance of the title, the moral given by this chapter, and of course, the question answers. But before we move along this session, let's start with the author, Catherine Mansfield, and know a little bit about her. Kathleen Mansfield Murray was born on 14th October 1888 in Wellington, New Zealand. She was a prominent modernist writer. She wrote short stories and poetry under the pen name Catherine Mansfield. Her noted short stories are The Garden Party, Miss Brill, The Doll's House, Bliss, The Fly, At the Bay, and many more. Mansfield was diagnosed with pulmonary tuberculosis in 1917 and she died on 9 January 1923, aged 34, in France. Do you feel you know your parents better now than when you were much younger? Perhaps you now understand the reasons for some of their actions that used to upset you earlier. The story about a little girl whose feelings for her father change from fear to understanding will probably find an echo in every home. This part of the sentence, will probably find an echo in every home, means that all children will feel the same way. So you all can relate to the feeling of little girl Kezia, just like she felt towards her father. Now let's read the story. To the little girl, he was a figure to be feared. A figure to be feared means a person to be feared and avoided. Every morning before going to work, he came into her room and gave her a casual kiss, to which she responded with, "Goodbye, father." And oh, there was a glad sense of relief when she heard the noise of the carriage growing fainter and fainter down the long road. Glad sense of relief means feeling relaxed. Fainter and fainter means to reduce in volume. In the evening when he came home, she stood near the staircase and heard his loud voice in the hall.
"Bring my tea into the drawing room. Hasn't the paper come yet? Mother, go and see if my paper's out there and bring me my slippers."
For this little girl named Kezia, her father was a person to be feared. She used to fear her father and try to avoid him because he was a very strict person. Every morning, whenever he was about to leave for work, he always came to her room to give a casual kiss, to which she always responded in saying goodbye. But that was a sense of relief for her because then whole day he wasn't present in the house and she used to feel much relaxed. That the noise of the carriage, which used to grow fainter when it moved down the long road, used to make her feel very happy. In the evening when he came home, she used to stand near the staircase and hear his loud voice in the hall. That loud voice used to make her feel very afraid of him. And her father had this habit of asking for tea, paper, and slippers. So he used to call his mother in a loud voice and order her to get all these things. Kezia, mother would call to her, if you are a good girl, you can come down and take off father's boots. Slowly, the girl would slip down the stairs. Slip down means come down quietly and unwillingly. More slowly, still across the hall, and push open the drawing room door. By that time, he had his spectacles on. Spectacles means glasses on his eyes. And looked at her over them in a way that was terrifying to the little girl. Terrifying means scary.
Well, Kezia, hurry up and pull off these boots and take them outside. Have you been a good girl today?
I don't know, father.
You don't know? If you stutter like that, mother will have to take you to the doctor.
Stutter means stammer or talk with continued repetition of sounds. Kezia's mother would call her to come down the staircase and remove her father's boots. But Kezia was so afraid that whenever she came down very unwillingly. And also across the hall, she used to walk so slowly that she was never excited to greet her father because of the fear that she had. When she came near her father had his spectacles or glasses on his face and he inquired whether she had been a good girl or not. To reply to that question, she stammered and she told that she didn't know. She stammered because she was so fearful that she got terrified whenever the father looked at her in that way. And when she stammered, her father told her if she kept stammering like that, then the mother will have to take her to the doctor. She never stuttered with other people, had quite given it up. Given it up means stop doing it, but only with father, because then she was trying so hard to say the words properly.
What's the matter? What are you looking so wretched about?
Wretched means unhappy.
Mother, I wish you taught this child not to appear on the brink of suicide. Here, Kezia, carry my teacup back to the table carefully.
On the brink of suicide, which means about to commit suicide. He was so big, his hands and his neck, especially his mouth when he yawned. Thinking about him alone was like thinking about a giant. So here the writer tells us that Kezia never stammered while she spoke to other people. It was only when she talked to her father that she lacked confidence. And that is why she tried very hard to speak properly and she stammered. Now when Kezia's father looks at her, he feels that something is wrong with her. And he asked her why she was so unhappy. It seemed as if she was just about to commit a suicide. And then he told his mother that she should teach Kezia to behave in a better way so that she doesn't appear as if she is so unhappy about her life. And then he orders Kezia to keep that teacup back to the table carefully. To Kezia, her father seemed like a giant. She felt that he was so big with his hands and his neck, and especially his mouth was so big whenever he yawned. So she had this impression that her father was not a very soft, emotional person, but rather he was a strict and a hard person, like a monster or a giant. On Sunday afternoons, grandmother sent her down to the drawing room to have a nice talk with father and mother. But the little girl always found mother reading and father stretched out on the sofa, his handkerchief on his face, his feet on one of the best cushions, sleeping soundly and snoring. Soundly means deeply, quietly. She sat on a stool, gravely watched him until he woke and stretched and asked the time, then looked at her. Gravely means seriously.
Don't stare so, Kezia. You look like a little brown owl.
One day, when she was kept indoors with a cold, her grandmother told her that father's birthday was next week and suggested she should make him a pincushion for a gift out of a beautiful piece of yellow silk. Kezia's grandmother always pushed her to have nice conversation or talk with her parents on every Sunday, because Sunday was the day when father used to be at home and everybody used to be very relaxed. Whenever Kezia went to her parents, her mother used to be reading and father used to be lying down on the sofa, sleeping and snoring. And his one feet used to be on the best of the cushions. So she used to sit on a stool and seriously keep staring at her father. And the moment the father got up, when he asked what time it was, he commented on Kezia that she should not stare like that, because then she looked like a little brown owl. One day, Kezia's grandmother told her that her father's birthday was approaching and she should make a beautiful pincushion as a gift for her father. So she gave her a piece of yellow silk. Laboriously, with a double cotton, the little girl stitched three sides. Laboriously means with a lot of effort or difficulty. But what to fill it with? That was the question. The grandmother was out in the garden and she wandered into mother's bedroom to look for scraps. Wandered into means went into by chance, and scraps means small pieces of cloth or paper, etc., that are not needed. On the bed table, she discovered a great many sheets of fine paper, gathered them up, tore them into tiny pieces, and stuffed her case, then sewed up the fourth side. That night, there was a hue and cry in the house. Hue and cry means an angry protest. Father's great speech for the port authority had been lost. Rooms were searched, servants questioned. Finally, mother came to Kezia's room. "Kezia, I suppose you didn't see some papers on a table in our room?" "Oh yes," she said. "I tore them up for my surprise." "What?" screamed mother. "Come straight down to the dining room this instant." So on the suggestion of grandmother, Kezia started to sew a beautiful pincushion for her father as his birthday surprise. And with great difficulty, she sewed up the three sides, but she did not know what to stuff into that. Since grandmother was out in the garden, she went into mother's bedroom to look for some pieces of cloth or paper which were not needed. And on the bedside table, she discovered many sheets of fine paper. She did not know what those papers were for, so she took them and tore them into tiny pieces and stuffed them in the cushion. And finally, she sewed the fourth side of the cushion as well. So the cushion was ready. But that night, there was a big anger in the house. That anger was of father. Father could not find that speech which he had written for port authority. All the rooms were searched, all the servants were called, they were questioned about it, but nobody knew anything about it. And finally, Kezia's mother walked into her room and asked Kezia if she had seen some papers on a table in their room. And to that, Kezia told her that she tore them up to make a surprise for her father. And then the mother also got angry and she ordered her to come straight down to the dining room at that very moment. Now let's see what happens next. And she was dragged down to where father was pacing to and fro. Pacing to and fro means walking from one point to another and back. Hands behind his back.
"Well?"
he said sharply. Mother explained. He stopped and stared at the child.
"Did you do that?"
"No," she whispered.
"Mother, go up to her room and fetch down the damn thing. see that the child's put to bed this instant."
The mother was so angry that she dragged Kezia down the staircase and brought her to where the father was. Father was also obviously very angry, so he was walking from one point to another point and then back with his hands behind his back. When the father asked Kezia whether she did that or not, Kezia stammered again, and because she was so scared, afraid of father's anger and fury, that she did not commit that she had done something like that, and so she denied. She said no. But then father told his mother, that is the grandmother, to go up to Kezia's room and fetch that damn thing. Now here the damn thing refers to the cushion which Kezia had made. And he refers that cushion in such a manner because he was very angry, was not very happy with whatever she made. And finally he told his mother, that is the grandmother, to put Kezia to bed at that very moment. Crying too much to explain, she lay in the shadowed room, watching the evening light make a sad little pattern on the floor. Then father came into the room with a ruler in his hands.
"I am going to beat you for this,"
he said. "Oh no, no," she screamed, hiding under the bedclothes. He pulled them aside.
"Sit up,"
he ordered,
"and hold out your hands. You must be taught once and for all not to touch what does not belong to you."
"But it was for your birthday." Down came the ruler on her little pink palms. Kezia was so disappointed and so fearful that she kept on crying, and she was crying so much that she could not explain why she did what she did. So quietly she lay in that shadowed room, in the dark room, watching that evening light which fell inside the room. And that evening light was making like a sad pattern on the floor because she herself was very sad. And then the father came into her room with a ruler or a scale in his hands. And he told her that he would beat her or punish her for whatever she did. She tried to hide behind the clothes, but the father pulled aside the clothes and told her or ordered her to sit up, holding out her hands. And he warned her that she should not touch anything that does not belong to her henceforth. Kezia tried to explain that whatever she did was for his birthday surprise, but the father did not listen, and then he hit her pink palms, her small, beautiful little palms, with that ruler. Hours later, when grandmother had wrapped her in a shawl and rocked her in the rocking chair, the child clung to her soft body. Rocking chair is a kind of chair which can move to and fro, and generally old people like to sit on this rocking chair. Clung means held on to her. "What did God make fathers for?" she sobbed. Sobbed means cried. "Here's a clean hanky, darling. Blow your nose. Go to sleep, pet. You'll forget all about it in the morning." I tried to explain to father, but he was too upset to listen tonight. But the child never forgot. Next time she saw him, she quickly put both hands behind her back and a red color flew into her cheeks. Now Kezia was so afraid she had got beaten. Her father had hit her small little palms with the ruler, and many hours later her grandmother wrapped her in a shawl and was trying to pacify her or to make her quiet. She made her sit on her lap on the rocking chair, and she was trying to put Kezia to sleep. Kezia tightly held her grandmother, but still she was not comfortable. She was crying, and she said that God should not have made fathers. She hated her father because she was so innocent that she did not know what wrong she had done. She was just preparing a gift for him. She was heartbroken and did not understand, and said that God should not have made fathers. Now Kezia's grandmother was trying to pacify her, so she gave her a handkerchief to blow her nose and to go to sleep. She explained to Kezia that she tried to convince her father that it wasn't Kezia's fault, but father was very angry to listen to anything. And so she advised Kezia to sleep so that she'll forget all about it in the next morning. But that did not happen. Kezia never forgot the beating that she got. And whenever next time she saw him, she always quickly put both her hands behind her back because of the scare or the fear that she had, and she used to grow red because of the fear. The McDonald's lived next door. They had 5 children. Looking through a gap in the fence, the little girl saw them playing tag in the evening. A tag is a children's game of catching one another. The father with the baby, Mao, on his shoulders, 2 little girls hanging onto his coat pockets, ran around and round the flower beds, shaking with laughter. Once she saw the boys turn the hose on him. Hose is a pipe to water the plants. And he tried to catch them, laughing all the time. Then it was she decided there were different sorts of fathers. Suddenly, one day, mother became ill, and she and grandmother went to hospital. The little girl was left alone in the house with Alice, the cook. That was all right in the daytime, but while Alice was putting her to bed, she grew suddenly afraid. Kezia had a neighbor, and they were named as McDonald's. Here in that family, they had 5 children. Once upon a time, she was looking through a gap in the fence, and she saw that they were all playing tag, a game which is of catching one another in the evening with their father. The father carried the little baby Mao on his shoulders, and 2 little girls and boys were all playing with the father. Once she even saw that the boys turned the hose on him, that is, they wet him with the pipe which is used to water the plants. But then also the father did not get angry on any one of them, rather he was catching them laughing all the time. So she saw a very happy family scene in the neighborhood, and she came to this conclusion that fathers are of different types. One father which she had was a very strict, a very hard person, but her neighbor's father was a very soft, a loving, a laughing, a playful person. So there may be different types of fathers. And suddenly one day her mother became ill. So Kezia's mother and her grandmother both went to hospital, and the little girl was left alone in the house with the cook whose name was Alice. Everything was all right in the daytime, but Kezia was afraid while Alice was putting her to sleep that what will happen when it'll be evening or dark. "What will I do if I have a nightmare?" she asked. "I often have nightmares, and then Granny takes me into her bed. A nightmare is a bad dream. I can't stay in the dark. It all gets whispery." Whispery means quiet. "You just go to sleep, child," said Alice, pulling off her socks. "And don't you scream and wake your poor pa." But the same old nightmare came. The butcher with a knife and a rope. A butcher here means a murderer, who came nearer and nearer, smiling that dreadful smile. Dreadful means terrible, scary. While she could not move, could only stand still, crying out, "Grandma, Grandma." She woke shivering to see father beside her bed, a candle in his hand.
"What's the matter?"
he said. Now Kezia was afraid that in the night, what if she has the same nightmare which she always has? And whenever she had that same nightmare, her grandmother used to take her into her bed. But today, neither grandmother nor mother was available for her. She was fearful of the dark because it all got very quiet during that time. She was a very innocent and a small child, so she did not know how to cope up with the fear of darkness. Alice tried to put her to sleep by warning her that she should go to sleep but should not scream and wake her poor father. But unfortunately, the same old nightmare came again. And in her nightmare, that is the bad dream, she saw that there was a man who was with a knife and a rope and he wanted to kill her. So he came nearer and nearer her, but she could not move. Kezia got scared and she cried out for grandma. When she woke up, she saw father standing beside her bed with a candle. And the father asked her what the matter was. "Oh, a butcher, a knife. I want granny." He blew out the candle, bent down and caught up the child in his arms, carrying her along the passage to the big bedroom. A newspaper was on the bed. He put away the paper, then carefully tucked up the child. Tucked up means covered up nicely in bed. He lay down beside her, half asleep still. Still with the butcher's smile all about her, it seemed. She crept close to him, snuggled her head under his arm, held tightly to his shirt. Snuggled means moved into a warm, comfortable position close to another person. Then the dark did not matter. She lay still.
"Here, rub your feet against my legs and get them warm,"
said father. When father asked Kezia what the matter was, Kezia tried to explain that she had a nightmare wherein she saw a butcher with a knife and now she wanted a granny because she was scared. But she could not actually explain what she saw. Father could understand the fear in his child, so he quietly blew out the candle, bent down and caught that child in his arms. He carried Kezia along the passage to his bedroom where there was newspaper on the bed. He set aside the newspaper and carefully covered Kezia in nicely made up bed. And beside her, he also laid down. He was half asleep. He was asleep, he was quiet. But in that quiet posture also, he had a smile on his face. And for an instant, to Kezia it seemed that the smile on the father's face was just like the smile on the butcher's face. Now what has happened here was that Kezia subconsciously used to feel that the butcher that she used to see in her nightmares was the same as her father, because both were fearful. But then she crept close to him, she came close to him and she snuggled, she moved into his warm arm and her head under his arm and held tightly to his shirt. And once she did that, she was no longer afraid. The dark did not matter then, and then she laid still. She was quiet and pacified. She was calm. And then the father told her to rub her feet against his legs so that the feet will get warm and she'll be more comfortable. Tired out, he slept before the little girl. A funny feeling came over her. Poor father, not so big after all, and with no one to look after him. He was harder than grandmother. Harder means stricter, but it was a nice hardness. And every day he had to work and was too tired to be a Mr. MacDonald. She had torn up all his beautiful writing. She stirred suddenly. Stirred means moved. And sighed.
"What's the matter?"
asked her father.
"Another dream?"
"Oh," said the little girl. "My head's on your heart. I can hear it going. What a big heart you've got, father dear." Kezia's father was very tired and he slept before her. And just then a very funny feeling came over her. Suddenly she felt sympathy for her father. Suddenly she felt that her father was not so big, but she worked all day long. He was strict. He was hard on her, but still he did so much for the entire family. And every day he has so much of work that he was too tired and he could not be Mr. McDonald, that is her neighbor. She now realized her mistake that she had torn up all his beautiful writing and he wanted that. And that is why on her mistake she was beaten up by the father. But when she put her head on his arm, she realized that her father had a very big heart. She could hear his heartbeat and she could sense the love her father had in his heart. So all the notions that she had about her father, that the father was a strict man, a hard person, an angry person always, was all washed away. And now she could feel the love in that same father's heart.
The little girl's name is Kezia. And in her family, there are four people, including her. Her grandmother, who's a very soft-hearted person, and she loved her grandmother very much. Her mother and her father. Kezia really feared her father because father was a very hard person. He was very strict. He used to speak in loud voice and she never saw him enjoying the life. All he did was work and sleep. So Kezia never formed a bond with the father as she had with her grandmother and her mother. Whenever Kezia's father left for office, she used to feel very relaxed and very happy. But whenever he came back home, he used to shout in loud voice and order other people, which really scared Kezia. She was hesitant to talk to her father. And whenever she spoke to her father, she stuttered or stammered. She was never confident in front of her father and her father always underestimated her. One day, the grandmother told Kezia to make a pincushion as a birthday gift for her father. And Kezia was such an innocent girl, she did not know what to put inside. So she picked up a few papers from her parents' room, tore the papers and stuffed them inside the cushion and sewed it all. But father was very angry at that, because those papers were really important to him. And as a punishment, the father hit on her palms with the ruler. The father must have forgotten this the next day, but this incident had a traumatic effect on Kezia's mind. She could never forget what wrong she did. She could never understand that. All she remembered was her father's stern and strict face, his angry face when he was beating her. When Kezia saw her neighbor McDonald, who played with his five children, who laughed, who was so joyful, who was so caring for his children, she made up an opinion that fathers can be of different types. One type is fathers who play with their children, and another type is like her father, who is very dominant and strict and never played with her. And she always thought that her father was different than Mr. McDonald. But in the heart of hearts, she wished she had such a father. And one day, Kezia's mother fell ill. So grandmother and mother both went to hospital and Kezia was left alone with her father in the house. During the day, Alice was there. Alice was the cook of the house. She accompanied Kezia there. But at night, Kezia had to sleep alone in her room. And Kezia often had this nightmare where she saw a butcher with a rope and a knife and laughing terribly to scare her. The same night, she had the same nightmare. And she woke up. She started to look or hunt for grandma, but she wasn't there. And then she saw her father standing beside her. Her father could understand that Kezia was really scared, so he picked her up and took her to his room. Kezia was still really scared, but she held on to her father. She snuggled into his arms. And when she went near him, she realized that father was not what he always seemed to be. He was a very gentle person. He had a big heart. He had so much of love in his heart for her and care for her That day, she realized this fact. And that night, she completely changed her perspective. She always felt her father to be a very strict figure of the house who always dominated over everyone. But that night, she could understand that her father was not that neighbor, MacDonald, who had all the time in the world to play with his five children. Her father was a very hard-working man who did not have time for her. And he slept so innocently. He was big, but he needed to be taken care of. And Kezia understood this. And she understood that her father was actually a very emotional, a very caring and loving person who dearly loved her. Under significance of title, we can see that this title is very apt for the story, because this story is about Kezia, who's a little girl. It is about her opinion, her experiences, her feelings for her parents. It is about what she underwent mentally and physically in her home. So the incidents which are described in this chapter very well explain the title of this story. Now coming to the moral of the story, I would say that you should never judge a book by its cover. What does it mean? That you should never judge your father the way he looks, the way he reacts to you. If you look within, you will find him to be a very soft person, a person who can love you the most and care for you the most in this world. Though men do not show like women, you won't find fathers as open as mothers. You will never find fathers so receptive as we find our mothers. Yet, they are very emotional from inside. You just have to look inside them. You just have to change your perspective towards them and find out the reasons why he is trying to discipline you or being strict on you, because he knows what's best for you. So in the nutshell, I would say fathers are like coconut, hard from outside but soft from inside. On this happy note, I end today's session and I'll be flashing you the question answers, and very soon I'll come up with a new topic in my next video. Till then, take good care of yourself, keep smiling, and have a happy day.